So you walk into the local sandwich shop and you discover that the person behind the counter is being discriminated against, being called names, all based on religious bigotry. What would you do? Would you step forward and do the right thing? More interesting, would an American serviceman who's faced with the same situation step forward and do the right thing? We have the video. You'll want to see it coming up next on Jim on History.
It's Jim on History.
Jim on History. It's Jim on History. Jim on History with Jim Heath.
So I started the Jim Heath channel about a decade ago to kind of showcase and highlight my broadcasting career, my reporting, my anchoring, my interviews. And one of the things I put on the channel really early on was a clip from the television program, What Would You Do? And it features an American serviceman who walks into a deli shop and discovers that the employee behind the counter is being harassed because of his religion. And it's generated millions of views. And I thought it was important to kind of share that here on Jim on History, because this topic, this debate, this discrimination of religion has been going on throughout history, from the beginning of humankind, really. And so I think that this whole question is something that we should continue to look at, continue to examine, and continue to ask ourselves, what would you do? What have you done? What do you think that you're likely to do if confronted with a similar situation? Look, we are in a free country. A country that was founded on the belief that everyone is entitled to have their own religious particular point of view, their own faith, or no faith at all. And yet this battle, this deep, deep hatred and battle over religion is something that confronts us all the time. So I thought what I'd do is we will play the segment. And at the end of the segment is the part that I posted here on the Jim Heath channel many years ago. And then we'll read some of your comments that you've left previously about this video, and we'll share those together.
Since when are they hiring Muslims around here?
Muslim Americans are no strangers to stereotypes.
Bet you go home and learn how to make bombs. Get on a plane back to Pakistan.
More than a decade after 9/11, hate crimes against Muslims are on the rise.
A woman in custody facing hate crime charges after telling police she pushed the man to his death because she thought he was a Muslim.
And the Boston Marathon bombing has them fearing even more backlash. We travel to the town of Kingston in upstate New York, not far from where a mosque was desecrated in 2010.
A racial slur was spray painted on the wall of a mosque.
And we've set up shop at the Home Plate Deli.
Home Plate Deli.
Can I help you?
Mina, the man behind the counter.
I'm playing the Middle Eastern victim.
And Oliver, the racist provoking him.
I am the bigot.
Are both actors.
I don't want a terrorist touching my food or taking my order. It's a terrorist behind the counter.
Not much reaction until this man speaks up.
What are you giving me a hard time for?
He's a Muslim.
Nothing you meant.
They want to blow up the whole country.
Not everybody's like that. We got to be better than that. You understand what I'm trying to say?
We are better than that. We're Americans.
Then get your and leave. You're pissing me off. Act like a jackwad in here in front of all these people. You don't
That's
have
right.
to carry on like a white.
Obviously, he bothered you.
Everybody's afraid to say something to him. I wasn't, you know. Look, I would have been happy just to deck him, but.
Good job, buddy.
Back at the deli counter, Oliver isn't talking turkey, but 9/11.
You Muslim?
Yeah.
I don't want an Arab Muslim taking my order. Could I talk to an American?
Let me take your order.
No. I don't want you to take my order. I didn't forget 9/11, buddy, okay? So Muslim, terrorists.
Do you want to buy this? Or do you
can't believe this.
Or do you want to leave?
You can't believe this?
I can't believe you. I feel like I'm in a dream right now. Is this really happening?
Do you forget 9/11?
I'm sure that kid was not involved in 9/11.
Relatives were. He represents his people.
Are you going to make that judgment of everybody that you see that looks different than you?
I know what an American looks like. I'm an American.
You know what an American looks like? And
yeah.
They're all white? Is that what you're saying?
No.
Say to her, look, I'm like your brother.
We're family. I'm just like your brother.
I would hope that my brother wouldn't act that way, dude. I hope that my brother never acts the way you're acting right now.
So you're clearly affected by it.
I have a little brother. I feel like a lot of young kids might think that way. They might be, you know, nervous about everything that did happen and not know. I don't think that it's right for people to act that way.
Over the course of the day, more customers stand up for our Muslim deli worker.
I think you're being inappropriate right now. If you're not happy, you need to leave.
I'm not okay with the way you're talking, man. You're being, like, so racist.
Everybody who's walking around like that is a terrorist?
He looks like one.
You're an idiot. I apologize for my friend here.
And then
you're an idiot.
This man.
Looks like a Muslim.
Yeah.
Speaking of idiot.
And I've been coming here a long time.
I hear you.
Yeah, right? Why'd they need to hire a Muslim, you know? Yeah. Could have been an American.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
We wonder, yeah. Does he really agree?
I mean, this is how it starts, you know?
Yeah.
No, start working at one of these places and...
Yep. Send all the money home.
Right. Well, and I'm worried about, I don't know, like a bomb or something.
Yeah, I don't trust anything.
Muslims say they hate our country. Death to America.
I know. I hear you.
I mean...
He's not the only one, man. You know what I mean?
No, there are a million of them. They all want to blow this place up.
Time for us to hear more from him.
You agree with what he was saying.
He was telling the truth, you know what I mean?
Some people watching this might say it's racist.
Well, yeah, some people might. It's kind of hard to
see
the difference between Muslim terrorists.
You're not saying they're all terrorists, are you?
No, I'm just saying it's hard to decide who's who. I mean, they blend in with regular communities.
Oh, my God.
Get regular jobs. You know, learn what they need to learn, do what they need to do, and then they strike. And then happens.
Now the final test.
He's a soldier. He's in uniform.
A member of the U.S. Army steps up to the counter.
Hey, don't deal with this guy. He's a Muslim.
Is he laughing?
Why is that funny? Okay.
Unroll.
Hold on. What happened?
This guy's a Muslim.
We live in America. He can have any religion he wants.
Aren't you fighting against these guys?
Not at the moment. Right now, I'm ordering a sandwich.
I don't think it should be working
here. Yes, fire chips and move out.
He doesn't follow orders.
Look, I'd like to order some food, just not from you, okay?
Get out. Put the chips down and go buy them somewhere else.
You want me to leave this place?
You have a choice to shop anywhere, just like he has a choice to practice his religion anywhere. That's the reason I wear the uniform, so anyone can live free in this country. Leave the man alone, buy your stuff, and leave.
Time to tell this soldier this is one battle he no longer has to fight.
How are you, sir?
How are you, sir?
I'm John Quinones with ABC's What Would You Do, the TV show.
You gotta be kidding me.
He was an actor. People might say that's very heroic, what you said. Is it?
No, sir. No, heroes come in many shapes and sizes, but that wasn't heroic at all. That was just being a person and standing up for someone else.
What principles were you defending?
Everyone's inalienable rights.
Everyone's?
Everyone's in this country.
If you're Muslim.
Everyone's. It doesn't matter to me, sir. If you're an American, you're an American, period.
Well, I happen to believe that the comments there by Specialist Fourth Class Bid of the United States Army are across the board representative of what the U.S. military stands for and the values they reflect. So his comments coming from someone in the Army are not surprising to me at all. It's across the general population where we continue to have problems regarding religion and race. And that's so unfortunate in a country that was designed to include everybody. That's what our republic is all about. All points of view, all religions, all races. But it just hasn't, unfortunately, worked out that way. So what we thought we'd do now is listen to some of your comments. Tens of thousands of comments left on this topic on the Jim Heath channel. Let's check out a few. All right, let's start with Fout A.
I'm proud of that soldier. A huge thumbs up for him. A real hero. This is the way everybody should be in this country, because USA is usually a country of freedom and not racism.
Freedom, not racism. Love the comment.
Strongest line for me. That's the reason I wear the uniform, so that anyone can live freely in this country.
Sagar Patel, well written. Thank you.
It was beautiful. The
but needless, more people like that soldier.
Totally agree, Jade Falstar. Thanks for the comment.
Guy, are you fighting these guys? Soldier, not at the moment. I'm eating a sandwich. Savage.
Savage indeed. Mark Sabo, I agree. Best comment.
Propaganda. BS. I call BS on these type of videos.
That was Specialist 4th Class Bid of the United States Army.
He's not a soldier.
He is.
It's staged, lol. And no one gets angry when people come in legally to work.
Member of the United States Army.
Pathetic. The character playing the bigot is right. The soldier is a damn fool and traitor. Islam is a cult, not a religion.
Wow. You could say that about all organized religion. Let human beings have their own individual faith. Stop being so obsessed with other people's points of view. Grow up.
Today, our soldiers are guarding our democratic institutions against domestic, conservative terrorists.
Good point. The attackers at the U.S. Capitol didn't look like the 9/11 attackers.
I am a Muslim, but it touched me so much. For everyone think like him, this word be massive. Salute to him.
Salute to you, Rose Day. Thanks for the comment.
Damn. This man is Captain America. I salute you, sir. Very inspiring. Makes me want to be a part of the army. God bless this great nation. God bless America.
Indeed, and that was reflective of so many of the thousands of comments left right here on the Jim Heath channel. I think what we just watched is representative of where we're at still as a country. Even though it's been decades since 9/11, it's been years since that report was aired, and yet we are still divided over religion and race in this country. And it's so unfortunate, considering that our republic was supposed to be the representative for the rest of the world. A way for all people from all around the planet to gather and be united under one flag, regardless of religion or race, sex or creed, with liberty and justice for all. And yet we have not lived up to that pledge. It's a work in progress. Are we better off now than 50 years ago? Certainly. Are we where we need to be? Not even close. And continuing to have a bias and a hatred of people simply because of their religion, their faith, their choice, or the color of their skin is just failing everything that our country is supposed to be. We can do better. We must do better. And I have a feeling a lot of you watching the Jim Heath channel right now are making an effort to do just that. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do so. Like this video. Please share this video. Leave comments. We'll probably revisit this topic again sometime in the future. But for now, thanks for watching Jim on History. See you next time. Take care.
So remember to subscribe to the Jim Heath channel and hit that like button. Thank you for watching.